We are going to start with Marcel Cartier, who I'm very pleased to welcome from New York. He's just moved here. He's a hip-hop artist, and he wanted us to keep the introduction as simple as possible. He's going to introduce himself with his work. Thank you, Marcel.
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. How's everybody doing? Feeling all right? All right, so like she said, my name is Marcel Cartier. I'm a hip-hop artist from New York City and just recently moved to London. I think it's interesting that everywhere I go now, I get reminded that I'm a citizen of the United States, more so than when I was in the U.S. And the reason I bring that up and the reason that I think it's significant is because when we talk about genocide, we talk about inequality, we think about oppression, we think about exploitation in the world, I think the biggest perpetrator of that is the United States, and I think the biggest threat to peace in the world is U.S. imperialism, which is basically the most advanced level of capitalism that we've seen anywhere in the world. And so if we're gonna have a society and a world free from inequality, if we're gonna have a society of freedom and justice, I think we have to pinpoint U.S. imperialism in alliance with Britain and its European powers as the major threat to peace and to equality in the world today. And I was sort of hoping that the woman that was here earlier, the heckler, would have stayed around for this particular piece that I'm about to perform. I actually wrote it 5 years ago during Operation Cast Lead. It's called Nakba, Free Palestine. I hope you enjoy it. Is it a horrible end or an end to the horror? All out war or a stop to the slaughter? People of Palestine living oppressed, little kids being bombed and maimed to death. Yeah, they bulldozing houses with families in them. That's straight state sanctioned terrorism, where your land's been stolen, identity crushed. No longer got a home and they cutting your phones. See, they cutting out electric and medical help. They cutting out food, trying to starve you to death. Israel illegal, colonial state with no right to exist. Still they being made rich, the help of these U.S. imperialists. Just check a little piece of these rare statistics. The U.S. gives billions a year, that's millions every day, people living in fear. See, it was knocked by then, it's knocked by now. Free Palestine, tear Israel down. Power to the masses, power to the people, emancipate humanity, then we all equal. It was knocked by then, it's knocked by now. Free Palestine, tear apartheid down. Power to the masses, power to the people, emancipate humanity, then we all equal. And peace is my goal, but never without justice. To be free, a prerequisite for that discussion. They talking peace, devoid of any context. They hope the people succumb to their nonsense. But Netanyahu is a fascist, a racist. Matter of fact, that's what the Israeli state is. Based on genocide, based on ethnic cleansing. Ethno-supremacy is what they're extending. These killers wouldn't last a day without the USA. Professional hypocrisy, that's Obama's way. Making speeches about democracy, man, it's master manipulation. I hope you see the first black president is bombing Africa. So quick to throw all them sanctions on Libya. But when it comes to their puppets in Bahrain or in Yemen, they never ever act the same. But it was knocked by then, it's knocked by now. Free Palestine, tear Israel down. Power to the masses, power to the people, emancipate humanity. Then we all equal, it was knocked by then, it's knocked by now. Free Palestine, tear apartheid down. Power to the masses, power to the people, emancipate humanity, then we all equal. And see, my heart is Palestinian, I bleed for the West Bank, bleed for the Gaza Strip, bleed 1948. I've seen that torment with my very two eyes, and I could never turn back or turn a blind eye. In the hood, the police beating black men. Connect the dots and you'll see who attacks them. The same forces who kill all across the globe. Afghanistan, the U.S. killing 9 and 10 year olds. They fighting terror with 100 times more of it. That's why Bin Laden existed to begin with. A misguided reaction to the empire. The last decade simply added to the fire. I'm pro-American if we just talking about the people, but anti-USA if we discussing all the evil perpetuated by this government of mobsters. They say democracy, I say they some imposters. Thank you.